So I try to start and hope some people can hear me. Streiflichter eines langen Weges or some brick. Ich krieg Hello. Hey. Okay. Kann man den ausmachen? Hello, I'm trying to start this session now. Streiflicht eines langen Weges or some brief remarks of a long history. I made English sheets, and I tried to do it now in English. Even my English is very poor. I'm often searching for expressions or words, and sometimes my grammar is a little bit strange. But I hope anybody will understand me. I'm Michael Stehmann, nearly 15 years active in the project. And I started with a database module and with BASIC. And I'm active in the BOOF team together with Mechthilde, my wife, and often with my daughter. And I'm also active to promote free software and open standards on some fields. And you'll find me under Mike Atwo at Apache.org. I want to start with a prehistory from Starwriter to StarOffice. In 1984 and 1985, Starwriter was created by Marco Burris. In 1984, there was a founding of Star Division in Lüneburg, that's in Germany, in Lower Saxonia. And in 1985, there was a distribution of Starwriter, and so Starwriter is older than Word from Microsoft. And after Mate, it was expanded to a complete Office suite and ported also to other platforms. And then in 1999, Star Division was acquired by Sun Microsystems, Peter told it. And so the history begins. In July 2000, the Office Suite becomes free software as OpenOffice. And the project start was in October 2000. So we will have a nice anniversary this year. And this project was started with community building. And in May 2002, version 1.0 of OpenOffice could be released. And that was an important moment for the project and the community and for the for free software. But we joined it a little bit later in November 2004. My student and me joined the project. And our special interests are Star Basic and the API base and database connections, especially to MySQL. And I'm a lawyer, and I need an office suite, and I want to have a free office suite in my office. I want to have free software in my office. But there was no free lawyers applications for German lawyers. So I started in 2007 with the developing of Kanzlei. That was an extension for OpenOffice written in Star Basic. And it has a database connection to a MySQL database. And in 2008, we could test it. And then we released Kanzlei in 2008. We joined the Germanophone project of OpenOffice. And our start was that we meet strong persons. I remember we are sitting on a weekend in our in my lawyer's office, and at that time each incoming mail makes a ping, and all the time there was ping, 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 and there was something like a flame war. But it was very interesting for us to see how the persons discuss the topics. And so we have a good impression how free software communities work. The Germanophone has two colleagues and a lot of contact persons, in German called Ansprechpartner, especially for marketing, for quality assurance, for the Mac port, for the Pro O box, for user support, for website, for documentation, and even for new members. And we have a lot of mailing lists. If you see just behind me, there are two roll-ups. This one we used recent at our booths, and this is an older one, and there are a lot of tasks or jobs written there, and some skills people can bring in, and the OpenOffice Org Deutschland e.V. was a non-profit association, and which supporters which supported the community and the project. We have an annual meeting called QA Wochenende or QA Weekend, and we have interesting discussions there, not only about QA, but also of all other topics on the project. And we have some other meetings like Treffen West, that or Meeting West, that was in North Rhine-Westphalia. And I'm from Düsseldorf, so it was my home meeting. And it take place on evenings, mostly in a pub, and there was a sometimes 10 persons or so, and talking about open office and all the things people talk, drinking beer, and so on. But then there are cuts. In 2009, the sun ain't gonna shine anymore. Peter talk about it. And in 2010, there was a fork, LibreOffice. And in 2011, Oracle donated the project to the ISF. Apache renamed the software and put it in the incubator. And we, Mechtilde and me, and a lot of, or some other friends, become initial committers. So, the history is going on. In 2012, we have our first release, version 3.4.0. And in 2012, also, Apache OpenOffice became an Apache top-level project. And in 2013, we have a new major version, version 4, especially with the new sidebar. In the meantime, we often call death, but we are still alive and try to find companions who works with us on in the project, and sometimes we get new persons who make valuable gifts to the project. I have to talk a little bit about the booths, etc. Since 2007, we visit FrostCon. That's a free and open source conference, which takes place in St. Augustine in the University of Applied Science there. It is a nice conference. We visit it nearly every year. In 1 year, we visit a Debian conference at the same time. And on the way back from Heidelberg, we make on Sunday in the afternoon a stop in St. Augustine. And there were people who have asked for open office, and so we get an and the other people says, okay, Michael and Mechtilde will come in the evening, and so there are still people waiting for us to ask us question about OpenOffice. That was a very interesting experience. And in 1 year, we have a dev room for free software for business and administration. That was a very interesting experience. And we also have some talks about OpenOffice there, but also on other topics. And so we were present every year. Yeah, and since 2009, we visit the Open Rhine Ruhr. The Open Rhine Ruhr started in 2009, and it was very important that we said, okay, Open Office will be where. And other people and other projects say, okay, if Open Office comes, we will come also. Since 2009, we visit FOSDEM. The Open Rhine Ruhr takes part in Oberhausen most of the time. So it was something like our home event. And since 2009, we visit FOSDEM, the Free and Open Source Developers European Meeting in Brussels. Oh, that's a very, very great meeting with a lot of people, 6,000, 10,000 maybe, joining it. Since 2016, we do it together with other Apache projects. And we also have a dev room at that meeting together with our friends from LibreOffice. We think it's a great experience to be there. And since 2010, we visit the Chemnitzer Linux Tage. We go from the Rhine area per bus to Saxonia. Chemnitz is in southern west Saxonia. And we travel by bus. And it is with our friends. And we have an own bus to travel there. And to even to travel back, and the journey is very interesting. Historic events are the Come to Linux, that which take part from 2005 to 2007 in Essen, that's the Ruhr area. It's now the Open Rhine Ruhr is the follower of this event. People who run the Come to Linux stopped it, and then other people says, okay, we need such an event in the Ruhr area, let's make the Open Rhine Ruhr. And so in 2009, Open Rhine Ruhr starts. We also take part, not but only as booth personnel, at the Linux Tag and the CeBIT, which takes place in Hannover. It was a very big IT fair. And there was also a place for open source projects there, and Open Office, and also Sun take part. It was very interesting to ask questions at the booth there. The booth material, you see the roll-ups. Stored at my lawyer's office or here at home, and we have I think we have good material for a booth. Sometimes we need newer materials, so we need maybe a new roll-up. We have a very new computer for the booth, with a and also a display and so on. Maybe we need some new flyers, but because this year there was no booths, we have still enough, maybe for the next year. Thank you. I'll try to donate the presentation. And maybe I will hold that presentation also on our anniversary celebrities, maybe in German. And so I have to ask for questions. And I want to invite you. Let us meet again on our 20 years anniversary celebrations. We can do it at that big blue button room here. And it's also open now, this room. So we can meet here in that room. This room is sponsored by members of the Chaos Computer Club. And it's under the German data protection law. So don't hesitate to join. So, we are ready. And this is the presentation for Mechthilde. So Mechthilde can start it. In a flying change. If there are questions, please use the chat. I will answer them, or join us here. Yeah, okay.
Ich habe versucht, ihn sozusagen das Mikro, nicht das Mikro, sondern den Ton auszumachen.
Das geht ja nicht. So, hello to all. Now I will start the presentation about our localization process for Apache OpenOffice. My name is Mechthilde Stehmann. I'm nearly 16 years active in this project and started first with translation and the database module, then QA, and I'm active at the Boost team. I'm also active in some other free software projects which are used in business, public, and private services. And this is especially, I'm also a member of the Debian project. Today, I want to present how it works to get translated version of Apache OpenOffice. How to translate a project depends on the size of the project. And I want to show you how we do it with Apache OpenOffice with a big, big code base. In the repository, we had nearly 115 languages, and 64 languages are also available in Poodle. Each language has nearly 90,000 strings in the UI and 440,000 strings in the help. This is very much strings to translate. And most of the groups who translate the strings are only two or three or four persons. Where is the translation done? We did the translation at translateapache.org. Here is a screenshot, the top of a screenshot of it. And now we can see the top of the UI translation with the total number of lines. We can see the help. And so what is Poodle? The committers can log in directly into it. Other volunteers write an email to Ellen at openoffice.apache.org with their preferred account name, and then they get an initial password. The Poodle itself, how does it work? The Poodle server has a web front end for the translators and a back end for the administration. And we use the translation toolkit to convert SDF file to PO and back. For Apache OpenOffice, we use the SDF file because it's a small character separated value. The whole process is an automation via shell script, which runs at the back end. The Poodle itself is the online translation management tool. This is the tool we see in the web. You can translate online the PO files. So it enabled collaboration and web-based teamwork. And in the background, you have a command line tool to manage it, to get also PO files or XLIF files. Translate.org.za released it. The Translate Toolkit is also a localization and translation toolkit. This transforms the or do the transformation from the SDF files to the PO files. And it is also released by the translate.org ZA. Here you can find the documentation for both tools. And here I show you two diagrams I prepared, and they are also published in our wiki, how the process, to give an idea about the process which we need for the translation. This is a link where you can find it in the wiki. We started with the improvements of the translation now for version 4.2 and for Trunk. Now it is possible to update Poodle with every milestone we want. We can export a translation from Poodle without painful problems, like in the past. All languages can be synchronized with the code. So if some new languages want, or some people come to translate OpenOffice in a new language, it is no problem to create some and export it to Poodle, and so they can translate it. There are also some groups which the translated code was in the source code, but not in the Poodle. And in the meantime, we also put them to Poodle so they can be translated there from the team. The first idea was a presentation from Andrea at FOSDEM 2018, where he demonstrates the problems of the translation process. And at the end of 2018, Matthias told to me, the translation is in a bad shape, and how can we improve it? And I say, it can't be so difficult to do a better translation. So, okay, I will start it. And then, yes, okay, now I'm doing the translation process. And also thanks to my husband, Michael, who has the last talk, he put the description in shell scripts, so the automation was easier to do. Q&A. If you have some question, please put it in the chat. Thank you. And me too want to invite you for the 17th of October at the Big Book Button for 20 years OpenOffice.org and 8 years top level project at the Apache OpenOffice. Okay. Hallo? So.
Then, you know, I look at it this way. I know damn well I couldn't do it.